Before we dive into this week's topic of the Econometrics 1 course, let me briefly discuss what this course is about so that you have the big picture of what we are going to do over the 5 weeks that we have. Now, what you see here is a small detail of a painting. When you see this, then you learn a lot about the technique that this painter used, but you have no idea of the big picture. So you don't know what story the painter wanted to convey. And in this case, actually, you know something about the technique that Van Gogh used to paint Starry Night, if you don't see the whole picture, then there's something that you miss out. And that's pretty essential, right? That the technicalities are only a means to an end. And this is something that happens a lot in econometrics courses, I'm afraid, that there's a lot of discussion of technique, but less discussion of how you use empirical analysis to convey a message, because that's in the end what you do. Econometrics is creative work. And what I hope to teach you in this course is how to use econometrics as a means to an end. So basically, in this case, to answer a specific type of questions, what is the effect of a treatment on an outcome? And a treatment can be a government policy or a business strategy. And how you do so, how do you do this creative work? Well, you have to recognize then opportunities for great research in the real world. And this is something that you don't do on campus. You'll have to get off campus and talk to practitioners, read trade journals and everything. And once you have completed this course, you have a better idea of what to focus on in those discussions. And also when you read magazines, on the topics that you're interested in, so that you actually know what provides great opportunities to answer questions like, what is the effect of this public policy on this outcome? Now, once you have completed the course, then that should also greatly help you to write your master thesis in the second semester. You should be able to find a topic more easily, a topic that is doable with the available data. And we'll be going through a lot of hands-on work in this course, so that you actually can code things in R, estimate things in R, interpret your output. So there's going to be lots of hands-on work, you know, lots of computer assignments that you have to do. So as you'll soon see in the course, I value practical wisdom over technical dexterity. So the technicalities are a means to an end. And in the end, you want to convey a certain message. A nice example of a thesis that did that well is from a student that followed the course last year. I put this thesis on Canvas in module 1. Let me briefly discuss what we do and don't do. Econometrics 1 is not so much about the specific channels by which a treatment has an effect on the outcome. But it's more about sort of the net effect by which this treatment affects the outcome. Let me explain what I mean by providing an example. Say that you're interested in the effect of airbags on the chance of a fatal car accident, then what we will focus on is sort of the total effect. And this total effect is is the summation of sort of the direct effect of airbags and lethal actions and indirect effects. Indirect effects are effects that are mediated by other factors. It can be that once you have an airbag, you drive less carefully. So you may be actually more likely to get into a car accident. So the net effect is actually an empirical question. But in econometrics one, all we do is estimating the net effect of airbags on lethal accidents. So mechanisms are not our primary concern. So in this sense, econometrics one is sort of answering black box question. So anything that happens between the treatment and the outcome is not of our concern. Our concern is with identification. So how do we actually estimate the effect? And this can only be done by having a comparable control group. And to get in a comparable control group, you need a research design. And design is something that you have to think about before doing your analysis. Running regressions is not something that you start with, but you will first think about your design, and then you actually come up with a certain specification, and then you can go to your data and run your regression. And Donald Robin puts this nicely, he says, by design, I mean all contemplating, collecting, organizing, and analyzing of data that takes place prior to seeing any outcome data. And basically what Enquist and Pisker do in their textbook is helping you with teaching 5 research design, their Furious 5. And this is how they were used over the last years in the sort of the best economic journals. That most popularly used is the instrumental variables design, and we'll start with the discussion of IV in week 3. Yes, and then the method that is least used is actually regression discontinuity design, which is actually discussed in week 4, I believe. So, and then difference in differences, the ID is week 5. Randomized controlled trials and the RCTs are discussed next week.